Hello, I was asked to do a video by Priscilla, and she wanted some tips and tricks of how to get some better ratings with being a teacher. She's already a teacher, but she just wanted a few maybe do's and don'ts. So this one's for you, Priscilla. Okay, the first one that I came up with is smile a lot. You should be smiling so much your face hurts. At the end of probably 3 or 4 classes, your face is going to hurt. And that's a good thing because it makes you look really happy and it helps the kids to be more excited. The second thing is use TPR. TPR is total physical response. So when you're talking, use gestures, use your hands. If you want the student to pronounce something, point to your mouth. If you want to let them know you're listening, I'm listening. Tell teacher. So you use a lot of hand gestures. You can go on YouTube and you can just type in TPR, and there are a ton of examples of how this works. And there are some really great videos out there, so I suggest you do that. Maybe in the future I'll make some as well, but I've already seen a lot of good ones. Use modeling. So if you're doing a lesson on maybe markers, if you have markers around, grab markers. Model. What is this? Marker. This is a marker. You can model. We have a lesson that talks about jumping and running and walking. I always say, jump, jump, and I show them jump. If it's running, running. Oh, teacher is running. Or I'll do walk, walk. Some of the lessons I'll do fly, fly. I will show them. So use a lot of modeling. If you have props, you can use props. This morning, actually, in my class, I did shapes and used shape cards to talk about the different shapes we were learning about. I do also have little finger puppets, especially at the lower levels. I will demonstrate sister, or mother, father, grandmother, grandfather. I have all these little puppets. I got them on Wish for like $5, if that, and it came with like six. Make sure you use the child's name so they know that you are addressing them directly, especially if the parents are in the room. They enjoy that you do that because it looks like you are giving full attention to that child, and that will help your ratings. Always be encouraging to the children. Some of them will struggle on pronunciation, or they'll struggle on understanding what's going on, or what you're talking about, or what you're asking them. So always just be really encouraging. And then after they do get whatever word or phrase you're trying to teach them, always give them that praise because that's really going to help your ratings as well. And also, it's going to help the child's self-esteem because, they finally got it. They understand what you're saying. Always use simple English. I know at first, when I first started teaching, this was really hard because I was just talking like I normally talk. So I had to break things down smaller. Especially, an example would be, before you get into class, I enter at 4 minutes. The system will tell you to enter at 5. I do 4. Sometimes when you enter at 5, it doesn't recognize you're in there. So I enter at 4, and then you have 4 minutes to spend with your students and get to know them a little bit before class. And so I will say, I'm teacher Sharon. And so I'll say, hello everyone, I'm Sharon. How are you today? I try to be careful about that. I'm teacher Sharon. And I'll have them repeat. And so just avoid any unnecessary words or phrasing and just break it down very simple. Always report things as needed. I've never had too much of a problem, but I have heard of other teachers. They've had students actually cutting their hair while on camera. One child was setting fire to things on her desk. And we have, it doesn't happen often, but we do have some children, and this is overall ESL online teaching, not just our company. Some children will actually expose themselves on camera. I don't know, sometimes this might not be intentional, but sometimes it is intentional. Just if you have any problems, just make sure that you report it right away. Our company, what they do is they call the parents. As soon as you report it, they will call the parent and let the parent know what's going on. Because if the parent's in another room, they just don't know. And you'll see the parent come in and correct the child or take away the scissors or whatever's going on. And they normally apologize profusely for their child's behavior. So just report things as needed. Also, take screenshots as needed. Once in a while, there are technical issues. It might be on your side, it might be on the company side. A lot of the times, it is on the company side. And so, just taking a screenshot. For instance, if you're in the middle of class and your screen freezes, take a screenshot. If you don't know how to do that, on my computer, I can just hold down print screen and then open up the paint program and control V and paste it in there. That way, it just kind of saves you in case there's something going on in the class with the software. Or if you enter a class and your student has not arrived and you're sitting there waiting your 10 minutes and the student never comes, you can screenshot that as proof that you were there and you still get paid. So that's pretty handy. Don'ts. Here's the don'ts. Don't eat on camera. The parents don't like that. I don't know why. They don't mind if you drink something, but if you eat, they don't like that. So don't do that. Yawning. For some reason, the parents get very upset if you yawn on camera. It makes them feel like you're tired, you're not invested in teaching. Sometimes they'll say you look worn out or you're just too tired to teach. For some reason, yawning is not allowed. And don't talk to others in your background. If you have kids coming in or a spouse or whoever, make sure you're staying here, you're staying focused. What I would do is just tell them, just a minute, you know. Or if you have a headset with a mute button, you can just let them know, hey, I'm still teaching, whatever. But keep your focus right here with your student. That will help you get better ratings. And sometimes you will get frustrated with something going on in the class. Just be careful of your reaction, and never take it out on the child. Sometimes it's hard, especially if they're being ornery and not wanting to sit down and focus and learn. I've had students just get up and go play in their bedroom, and I would try to coax them to come back. Come on, Peter. Peter, do you want some more? Look, teacher has diamonds. Do you want more diamonds? Try to coax them back. If you cannot get them back after just a few seconds, don't waste your time on it. Just mute them and keep going with your other students. That way, those parents don't feel like you're using up a lot of time to focus on this other child that's obviously not wanting to learn. And one thing that I will note is never post a screenshot of your classroom with the child's faces and names on social media. I've seen on YouTube a lot of teachers have done this, even using examples of their classroom, and you can see the child and their name. For privacy reasons, you should never do that as well. I wouldn't want my children, you know, their image being posted out there. So just a tip for everyone, please don't do that. Two quick myths about ratings. First myth is that you'll get better ratings if your hair is up. I have trialed this. I've done a solid week with my hair up, a solid week with my hair down. I've learned personally that as long as you're a good teacher, that doesn't matter so much. Some parents are very strict and picky, and they do prefer you to be very professional. But if you're a good teacher, your teaching skills kind of override that. Second myth, real quick, is makeup. When I first started, I wore makeup every class. I thought it was more professional, it gave me a better image, and I've done it with and without, and my ratings haven't changed. So I continue to have good ratings. So I will make a list of these do's and don'ts. I will post them. I hope this helps. Thank you so much, and I will talk to you guys later.